Hello and welcome to a new video on the Crypto 2 YouTube channel. This is a video that was actually not planned for this day, and I wanted to make a video about cost functions and text frequency analysis and so on, but since we had such great news today, I had to make this video. And the news are that David Oranchak, Sam Blake and Jarl van Eycke solved the Zodiac 340 cipher. So as you can see here, I'm right now on David Oranchak's YouTube channel, and David Oranchak is probably the expert for the Zodiac Killer ciphers. And he, together with his two other guys, they solved this. So at first, of course, when we get a solution to the 340 ciphers, as we had several over the last years, I thought, oh, that cannot be true. But David Oranchak, he's known for not joking with this, so actually it's really true. But of course I had to check if it's true, and I was really interested in checking this. So before you watch this video here, or go on watching this video, I suggest that you go to David Oranchak's YouTube channel and first have a look at his video. And in his video he shows how he and his team solved this cipher. And from this point now on, these are spoilers, so go to the site and or to the YouTube channel and watch this video first. Then go on if you want to try it by yourself. And so what did I do? First, of course, I watched David's video, which is really great. So he makes really great videos, well made, very interesting. I watched all of his videos in his series and they're just great. And in this video here, as I said, he shows how they actually solved the cipher, and this was only a few days ago that they, or they published it only a few days ago, or it's, I think also this could is the publication or the announcement that they solved it. And of course they went to the FBI and gave them their solution, and they also checked the solution, and they said, as I read, that the solution is correct, and I also can confirm that this solution is correct. And so in his video we can see, or he tells us, that the cipher is not only a homophonic substitution cipher. You know homophonic substitution ciphers from my channel, and you probably have seen my Zodiac Killer video, or Zodiac Cipher Killer video, about the solved cipher, or the previously solved cipher. And this was only a homophonic, or only, it was a homophonic substitution cipher that Zodiac used. And with this cipher here, as many people also believed before this solution now came up, is a transposition and homophonic substitution cipher. And David really nicely shows us how this works. So Zodiac started in this left corner, and then he went this diagonal way through the text. And to decrypt it, you have to read out it this way. So you start here, then you go two to the right, one down, two to the right, one down, two and so on and so on and so on. And in the end, you wrap around the X and the Y axis. You will see what I mean in the next diagonal, because we have a missing character then. And we go to this here. And then with the next diagonal, we go to this and go on here. So, of course, as a computer scientist, I first thought, okay, how to program this and how to read it out. So I wrote a quick and dirty console application. I have here the ciphertext part, so the first block of the ciphertext as shown here. And I obtained that ciphertext from the Zodiac Killer Cipher wiki. So zodiackillerciphers.com, here's a wiki. And in the wiki, you can find a transcription of the cipher. And actually, this is a link to David Oranchak's webpage. And I copied the first 153 letters. The first 153 letters are this block here. And this is a part of the transcription I used here. And then I just programmed it down, like you have an X and a Y coordinate. And I have a counter that I know that I have enough read out, because it wraps around, and of course it would start over, start at the beginning again when it reads the end. And we read it out by the coordinates X plus Y times 17. So this is the X and Y offset of our ciphertext. And of course, in every step, we increment the x coordinate by 2 modulo 17. That's how we wrap around. And we do the same with the y coordinate. And this gives us a pattern to just easily read out the intermediate ciphertext, so to reverse the transposition cipher. And when we just start it, the console application, of course, pops up, and we can just easily copy the intermediate ciphertext. And now in the second step, we have, of course, to break the homophonic substitution cipher. To be honest, the homophonic substitution analyzer in Crypto 2 is right now not powerful enough for such a short cipher. So it is really incredible the tools they use that they could solve this homophonic substitution cipher. But I, of course, wanted to try my own homophonic substitution analyzer that I use for historic ciphers, for instance. But of course, the historic ciphers I solve have much more letters than 153. And then to break it with this component, or to decrypt it, you have to change the use spaces here. And then our ciphertext format are single letters. And then we can just start the homophonic substitution analyzer. Now we have our ciphertext here. And when we press the analyze button, it starts to search. But as I said, we have a lot of homophones. We have 63 different homophones. And we have very few ciphertext letters. So I stop this right now. And what I will do is, I want to, here's the solution that David Oranchak gave us. And my idea to check if the solution is correct was that I copy the first sentence and then try to find out if the rest of the block also decrypts to the rest of this here. So we have here I, then we have hope you, H-O, and I will make a little more space here. Hope. U. And the next part is are having. Are. And now we see the first letter that fits. So we have the H here and it fits. So this works. And the idea, of course, to when you want to prove a solution to a ciphertext is you want to find things that don't match, like symbols in the wrong places. And of course, if the rest makes sense. So you are having, was having, yes, having. And lots of fun. And as you can see, we have a lot of homophones. Lots. And then we have the next homophone that also fits. We have the O here. And then we have two times the same homophone. And this is the F. Off. Now we have the U, N, lots of fun. In trying, in. Up to this point, it could be a wrong solution, but we see a lot of many homophones here that could make sense. So we go on, lots of fun, in. And then we have trying. And then came the point where I was believing this could be right, because we have the Y here. Then we have the I. And then we also have NG2, trying to. So this also works, the same homophones, trying to. Then we have catch, the C here. And the A. And the more homophones in the first part we solve, or we assign to the correct plaintext letters, the more the remaining cipher plaintext is solved, and it makes sense, as you will see. Then the T here, catch, me. Now we have the me here. Me. That wasn't me. So we have an A here. That. W. S. N. Me. And then we have that wasn't me on Z. So we have an O here. On the TV. So this TV also works. Then we have here also how, but this is of course, sorry, an S, show. Then we have which brings, and this also works. We have which here nearly complete. Which show, which, so here we have a small error because we have here an H two times. Which brings, and David also says that the Zodiac of course made some errors, bring bring which brings, here we have an S, and here we also have a small error, bring which show. No, here's no error. I'm stupid. This has to be a W, which brings up. Which brings up. T U up. A point up. Which bring TV. On the TV show, which brings up a point. This has to be. Oh, I made the error here. This is an O. This is point here. T is it. That wasn't me on. I'm trying to catch me. That wasn't me on the TV show, which bring having lots of fun in trying to catch me. That wasn't me on the TV show, which bring up a point about a point. This is about me. About me, I am not afraid. I am not afraid of, and we have the, and now it's gas chamber. Because it, and this also fits, will, I think it's because it will, yes, will and then we have sent. Me, and then to paradise, and here also David mentions is an error, so we have here peru paradise dice, all the... So again, I hope you are having lots of fun in trying to catch me. That wasn't me on the TV show. David also mentions in his video a TV show at the time where someone called the into the TV show and said he's a Zodiac. And the Zodiac is responding here that it wasn't him. So where were we? On the TV show, which bring up a point about me. I am not afraid of the gas chamber because it will send me to, and this is paradise or the, and then it goes on. And the remaining parts you can try by yourself. So David really nicely explains how this solution works. And as you can see, you can easily do it by yourself. So I'm 100% convinced that this is the correct solution to the Zodiac Z340 cipher. So, David and your team, that was really a great work. I'm really stunned, and it's just amazing. So, thank you for doing this. So, after so many years, trying to solve this cipher is really great. Yeah, this was everything that I wanted to show you here on my channel. So, as I said, please watch the video. It's just great how they did this. And next week I will go on with the regular things on my channel, and I will make a video about language statistics and cost function and so on. So yes, thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.